We're excited. 5 days. And I think our guys are excited. We're working hard and getting close to the time. But that being said, should I answer the first question? Or
yeah, go ahead. Answer it. Answer it.
So we have a really good plan. We're excited about it. Because we kind of figured it out the last day or two, we just really don't think it's an advantage to us to tell you our strategy right now on that position. And so pretty much announced that starting quarterback game time. And we thought it helped us, or it was 3 weeks ago or a month ago, but because it's been so late,
so you've named the starter and you just haven't announced it, is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. And it's just one guy who's not. The two quarterbacks can use.
Two quarterbacks could, three can be used. We like I said, we've been looking at this obviously since spring and every day since then and analyzed every rep. And so we think we got it. Like our whole team, it's work in progress, and it's going to continue to work in progress. We don't expect anybody to be perfect out there. We do expect guys to improve, and give us a chance.
You play the area like coach. How hard is it to tell two other guys that they're not a starter? What was the reaction?
Well, here's what I think is that it's hard at any positions, but I also think we do that in every position. It's no different than the quarterback position, which I think is, maybe somewhat unique. And we take time to make sure we talk to our guys and say, hey, here's what we see, what way you want to jump, and this is what you need to do to improve your game. And so that's in all positions. And so we try to make a big deal about this is where you are, and nothing is set in stone. And we like competition to continue, and they just keep at it. And it's just interesting to look over time. Kids just hang in there and keep fighting. How that can happen in a good way. I mean, that's just, it's amazing. How that usually turns out for guys to just keep fighting, keep competing, keep improving. Really a hard concept to get there. Because we're so hung up on what coaches think, how the other guys are competing against are doing. And so we really try to spend a lot of time talking to these guys about that. That's, you can change your focus to just do it, just keep doing your best. Very often, really good things happen for you in the process.
Just from your standpoint, why is it better to not publicly name a starter who maybe you know there's going to be a rumor and speculation floating around between now is the time that it is made public?
We would like rumor and speculation. As much as you can do for that, that would help us. Our guys know what's going on, and that's the important thing. And so 5 days for the thing, that doesn't really help us a whole lot. So come up with a bunch of different scenarios. That'd be good for us.
By saying though that three quarterbacks could play, is it safe to say that Jake will not be a redshirt coach?
It is safe to say that we have a good plan, and on Friday we'll see.
Chris, since you weren't able to name a starter at the beginning of camp, for instance, how much did this plan evolve over the course of the fall, depending on what you saw on field and what you saw on tape?
Very much so. I mean, I think each day, what we did after a while was just try to back away from it and not talk about it every single day. Because there would be kind of a string of thinking, maybe this would be the best plan, this could be a few days, and a few more days go by, and say, this could happen. So we've analyzed this thing ad nauseum. Day, it just kind of all felt like, hey, this is our best plan going into this. And I think the coaches feel good about it. The quarterbacks were awesome about it. They really were. And there we go.
In our latest latest caller. Please hit star 6 on your phone. Please, we're getting some background noise. Thank you.
Chris, how much of the atmosphere is going into Boise? Can you tell us what that atmosphere is going to be like going into Boise?
Well,
and did that weigh into your decision?
I think when your game is billed as the biggest game in school history, I don't think you have to do a lot of describing. I think using those words just take care of it. It's a great place to play. I mean, unbelievable home field advantage. The size of the stadium has nothing to do with it. It's very passionate. That's why I think we have our plan to go forward. And certainly we don't want guys looking over their shoulders. You know, I've said this since spring, I've said this forever. It's been such a long season, and things happen between injuries and performance and just all those type of things. And so we're kind of all in this together. It's not on anybody's one shoulder. We're a team here, we're a staff here, we're going to do the best to support that group. And heck, if that guy plays well, probably starts in the old line, giving him a chance to do some things. Giving him a chance to run when he gets off. You know, that guy gets a lot of arrows pointed at him. And sometimes unfairly, and sometimes rightly so, but it's the most scrutinized position out there, so he's kind of been like those.
Ask you about this before. You've never had a true freshman quarterback. What is it about you?
And we might not have a true freshman.
Yeah, I'm saying, what is it about Jake Rennie that you're considering?
I don't think Jake's a true freshman. And I don't think it really matters.